Brothers and sisters, the Lord is with you.
And also with you.
We continue listening to God speak to us from the Gospel in the tradition of Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
When the Pharisees heard that Jesus had silenced the Sadducees, they gathered together. And one of them, a scholar of the law, tested Jesus by asking, "Teacher, which commandment is the greatest in the law?" Jesus said, "You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind. This is the greatest and the first commandment, and the second is like it. You shall love your neighbor as yourself. On these two commandments hang the whole law and the prophets." This is the gospel, the good news of our salvation.
Praise
the Lord. By word to the gospel, may our sins be blotted out.
Amen.
We have a letter from Bishop Frank Betancourt, who is the director of vocations for CASINA, Catholic Apostolic Church in North America. And this weekend, we're celebrating Vocation Weekend. He begins with, "My dear brothers and sisters, it is very good for us to gather together in worship to offer praise and thanksgiving to our God. In doing so, we help one another build community as we come to know one another and how we might make our faith communities stronger. Our God calls each of us to share with the larger community our gifts and our talents. Yes, each of us has a vocation to serve. Some of us have been called by God to serve the community sacramentally, as a priest or deacon. As the vocation director for the Catholic Apostolic Church in North America, I work with those who are discovering a call to the ordained ministry. You have been blessed as a community to have your Franciscan brothers serve you. These men answered God's call that was born into their hearts. We as a church give thanks to God for their dedication and service. Remember to pray for them each day. Our God continues to call men and women to serve our communities by ministering the sacraments. Those individuals can either accept or decline the call. Acceptance calls for an individual to offer themselves bodily, spiritually, and physically in service. A call comes not only from our God, but from the community as well. Many of our priests and deacons have come to serve from within our own faith communities. Let us join together in prayer that those called will seek the path to ordination. Let us be supportive of those men and women in order that our communities continue to grow both in faith and in numbers. And may our Lord God continue to bless you as we pray for one another. Your brother in Christ, Frank Betancourt, Vocation Director." Very nice letter indeed. And Bishop Frank, whom we met at the General Assembly in Pennsylvania in May, is also a Franciscan. We are not part of the same community, but within Franciscanism, the bond that joins us together is the spirit of Francis. As he said in the letter, it's important that each one of us prays for church. Prays for allowing us who are ordained, as well as the brothers who aren't, to continue to serve you. Brother Chris, as you know, has applied for a diaconate, hopefully which will lead to ordination to the priesthood. And we need to have other people involved. It's very important to the life of this parish, to the life of the church in general. we listen to the scripture tonight, as I said at the beginning, the first reading talks to us about who we should consider to be brothers and sisters. The question on the back of the bulletin asks the same question. Those who we don't particularly like, we might consider, well, we don't have to worry about them. But one thing, and I've said this many times, as Father Vinny has as well, we're not called to like everybody, but we're called to love one another. Not only did we hear that in the scripture tonight, but what we hear it also is in Jesus' last will and testament, the night of the Last Supper. He tells us very simply, to love as I have loved you. Without any sort of question. Do we like the people that cut us off online in Publix? Do we like the people that cut us off on 95 or the turnpike? Do we like the people that turn without giving signals? No, of course not. We don't like them. But what we're called to do is that if we see anyone in need, we're called to lend a hand. We're called to show that love and that respect that we ourselves want. There's something I read, and it's, I'm sure we're all familiar with Elizabeth Barrett Browning. And she says, how do I love you? Let me count the ways. And this is what we're asked to do, to love. Without counting the manner, the way of love. The interesting thing about this particular gospel from Matthew is when we're seeing the leaders of the temple, they're getting very anxious because they're realizing that this Jesus, this itinerant preacher, is causing concern to them. And he's causing concern to them because he's drawing people away from them. And you get two groups coming together, the Pharisees and the Sadducees, who were constantly blocking heads, okay? Constantly in conflict with one another. And what do? They put their conflicts aside to try and trap Jesus, as the question last week in the scripture was too. They try to put him on the spot. And again today, asked by a lawyer, a scholar of the law, what is the greatest commandment? And as last week Jesus said when they questioned him on the paying taxes to the emperor, show me the coin. Again, trying to trap him. And they very simply, what does he give them? He gives them the law of Moses. Very simple. This isn't something new to them. In fact, as Jesus was preaching many times, excuse me, one of the things that Jesus always said when he was questioned about distorted what he was teaching, it was always, I have come to fulfill the law and the prophets. The law, tonight we loving God and loving one another. Who is my neighbor? Who am I called to love? Think about it. Pray about it. And while you do that, pray for me as I pray for you. And may God bless us and keep us. May God's face shine upon us and give us peace. Now and always.
Amen. Amen.